Today we're going to talk about the BigTreeTech TFT35. Now I need to point out a couple of things on the front panel of this so that you can understand. It's a touch screen, but you can also use it like a RepRap Smart Discount full graphics display. You have a potentiometer for a knob so you can turn it and then push it in order to select what you're looking for, or if you're using touchscreen mode, you can touch the screen. Over here we have a piezo buzzer, and here we have a reset button. On the back of the TFT35, we have a couple of things I need to point out here. Starting with, we have our ports for an LCD. There's EXP3, there's EXP2, and there's EXP1. Over here we have our connection for the TFT display, and then over here we have our ST card reader. We also have the ability to read from a USB port over here, and then we have a couple of interesting connections. We have our 5-volt connection if you want to run power directly to the display. Then we have our filament runout detector right here. We have our automatic shutdown after printing here. We have a UART3 and a UART4. And over here, they haven't really defined in their documentation yet what this is, but I can tell you that they have a Wi-Fi port right here. As you can see, it's got a... A 32-bit processor that I believe is an M3. Okay, as you can see right now, I have the LCD connected. I'll show you how to do that in just a moment, but I wanted to show you that we do have two modes on this. We have our LCD mode, and then if we want to swap the mode, we hold this button down, and we can scroll up to the serial touchscreen and push down. So in a second, I'll show you how to actually set this up first with the LCD mode. Okay, to start to set this up, first thing we need to do is take the notched connector and connect it to our LCD for the EXP1 connection. Then we're gonna do EXP1 on our BigTreeTech SKR version 1.3. Next, we're going to move over and we're going to do the version for the EXP2, and we'll slide that notch connector in, and then we'll move over and we'll connect EXP2 over here. Now, just keep in mind, I purchased this LCD with my own money, and I'm not being sponsored to do this tutorial by anyone, but I will be putting Amazon affiliate links in the description to help you find it or buy it if you so choose. So to set up and program the LCD, we need to connect our big connector to the SKR, and our small connector we need to connect to our computer, so you may hear a beep in a moment. And then we need to switch this into the mode that we're using for the LCD. So we're going to push down and we're going to change to LCD simulator and push down again. Okay, as you can see, we have the USB connected, so we can see that it currently has an old version of firmware on here. Note the time. Now we're going to go over to VScode and we're going to do add folder, and we're going to add the unzipped version of Marlin-2.0.x. It's no longer bug fix, and we're going to add that. And inside here, we can then see what we're going to be working with. So as you can see, we have Marlin. And then down below, we have our source folder. So we're going to go there. We're going to go to the core folder, then boards.h. Inside here, we're going to search on BigTreeTech. or excuse me, BigTree underscore SKR, and we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of boards.h, and we're going to go to configuration.h. And inside configuration.h, we're going to do a search on motherboard. And we're going to replace board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB with what we just copied. We're going to paste it here. Then we're going to scroll up. We're going to change the serial port to -1. And then we're going to do a search on LCD and SD support. And I'm going to show you a couple things here because a lot of people use different languages. You can see that there's a two-letter designation for the language that you might use. Like RU is Russian. PL, I believe, is Polish. And then we have French and Spanish. But in this case, we're going to use English, which is EN. Another couple of interesting things down here is you can pick your type of character set, such as Japanese, Western, or Cyrillic. We'll leave that alone for now. And then you have a choice of styles that you can use. You can use the Classic, or you can use Prusa. So right now we're going to go with Classic. And then we have SD support. So in order to use the SD card, we have to remove the comment so we can support SD. And then there are various other things that control, you know, the movement of your LCD with the potentiometer and other things that you can experiment with. But I'm going to skip that for now. What we're going to do right now is we're going to search on full underscore graphic. And what we're looking for is the RepRap discount full graphic smart controller. So we're going to remove the comment here so that we can actually use it. And I would show you the other things, how to configure your steppers, but I think most people are just interested in how to set up their LCD. If you want more information on that, you can always consult my other videos on steppers. So we're going to go over now and we're going to find platform.io.ini so that we can set it up to compile. Currently it's on its default environment, which is Mega AT Mega 2560. So we're going to replace that with LPC 1768 because that's our chipset. And then we're going to do an upload, which will compile and then upload our changes. Now you can either check it right here with the forward arrow, or you can go up to, I believe, here. Let's see if I can find it. Oh, sorry. Here it is. And click upload. Okay, as you can see, now that the compile is finished, we now have firmware.bin in lowercase. And note the time of that. Now I want to show you something. Over in VS Code, we can actually check to see that our actual build completed by scrolling up here. And our chipset being the LPC 1768 completed successfully. Okay, now that we know that it's completed successfully, I'm going to actually remove the USB and let you see what happens on the LCD when I plug it back in. So I'm going to remove it. And now I'm going to place it back in. And as you can see, the Marlin has loaded for the RepRap discount full graphics smart controller. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.